evening, Narendra.
Good evening, Sam.
Welcome to the 41st event of the Indian Networker and the 59th episode of Jam with Sam.
Very nice.
Thank you so much for coming finally. He goes all over the world. Suddenly he goes to Mongolia also. I said, what do you do in Mongolia over there? You know, you'll get a lot of yaks and all over there. So let's get straight. Tell us something about your education. I mean, where did you start? Where were you educated? And till the time you got to your first job, and stop there, then I've got the next question over there.
All right. Born and brought up in Mumbai. And got educated in Mumbai, did my graduation, and then while I was graduating, I got into a company called Hawkins, and it was a summer vacation job. I picked it up out of my interest to earn something while I was studying, and somehow it turned into a serious career. Hawkins actually failed into one of their project, which was very rare to happen there because it's a very strong company. And they've got a very strong systems, but yet the product failed. And the chairman was not ready to accept that defeat. So he said, no, I wish to try again before we really give it up. And they picked up five young, he said, give me five young, bright, sincere workers. And I'll tell them what is to be done. And I was one amongst those five. And then we started to work on that very product. It became so popular that it got relaunched at the dealer space, and then it went all over the country. And then I was absorbed into the main system called Hawkins Coopers Limited. And after 3 years down the line, I became regional manager, then the zonal manager. And then I was about to become a GM, but I said, yeah, it will be too much to be into the pressure cooker.
So, it will be like a pressure cooker only.
So I said, let me change the product. So I got into the bag, from the pressure cooker to the bag. And
so what was your kind of profile like when you started in Hawkins? I mean, what is the kind of, which year was this?
It was 1984.
You got in over there. And you was just like a marketing executive kind of job, was it over
there?
Yeah,
it was called as consumer contact representative.
Wow, it's a fancy term. That sounds good over there.
Consumer contact representative.
So this was actually selling those pressure cookers?
No, actually a product which was which used to operate on electricity.
Okay.
It was not so known in those days, and basically it used to cook, grill, make a sandwich.
Acha. Okay.
Make a cake,
okay.
But in 6 minutes, 5 minutes, because the mode of cooking was infrared. So uh-huh. Infrared has a capacity, you know, feature to cook things internally.
Okay. Better than microwave.
Safer than microwave.
Safer than microwave. Okay. So that's good. Okay. So then, how long were you in Hawkins?
I was there since 84 to 1998.
So it was 14 years in one company. Wow. And some the other speakers would come. I'm going to speak later about it. How many companies she was in? So so when I was making it, I was like, okay, only one and two. Okay, fine. So then, what made you take that break? I mean, what? How did you get into Samsonite?
I'll tell you. See, what happens is when you start to do extremely well, either you stick to something when you are struggling, that you want to excel. But the moment you have reached to a stage that you have done anything and everything possible, given the scenario, then you start to think, yeah, capacity, kuch aur check karte hain. Let's see what else can be done in life. And I took that little challenging step to get into a new, new brand in India. Samsonite was not known in India. And VIP was the brand which was known.
Yes.
And that is how.
So VIP is the suitcase as well as that undergarments also? They're the same company?
No. VIP garment is a different company.
Okay.
And the VIP industries is only
separate
the luggage,
company. Okay.
The bags.
Trademarks.
Yeah.
Ramu's listening. Okay. So tell us about Samsonite. I mean, everybody knows, you know, when you get into a local train, that was a deadly weapon. People had a briefcase. So when you would get a local train, no, first the guy will give one with a briefcase, you're like, ouch, you know. So it was a VIP and Ecolac. I think that time. And Samsonite, when I started my career, my father had a Samsonite bag over there. In the Gulf, like Samsonite was, it was the brand over there. And my name being Sampat also, so Sam and Samsonite well, very well over there.
Really?
So I had picked up, I still have that briefcase over there with the Samsonite. I think it's more than 20, 25 years old. So I'd gone to Musafir Khana, you know, where you get all your smuggled stuff over there. And I bought that. And that time, that was costing some 2,000 rupees at that time. So and that is the briefcase I used to go for calls, you know, computer Mukesh, remember those days over there? Go for calls with that and that. Oh, you have a Samsonite briefcase. Oh, wow, you know. Must be a good rich engineer over there coming with that. So Samsonite was born over there, but it was available in the grey market only.
Yeah.
So tell us something about the brand of Samsonite before it came to India and then after it came to India over there.
See, the globally, Samsonite was very, very well positioned. It was doing great. But in India, the situation was extremely different. Meaning the price of Samsonite used to start at 4,000 rupees in those days, those years, and where competitive product of VIP used to stop with its premium range at 1,000 rupees. So 1:4. The customers were not really ready to buy and pay the four times the value. More so, the traders who could have otherwise shown it to the customers and created a played a role of a platform were actually arm twisted by VIP. Arm twisted meaning literally arm twisted.
Okay.
Although, as I was telling off the record, that MRTP do not allow you to do that. So well, within the MRTP, the things were managed very, very well. So when I joined the office, I saw the first day, not first, maybe third day, some truck coming in and they were bringing in some signages. I said, are these defective one? They said, no, this is not defective. It is good in shape and size, but then it's returned by the dealer. I said, then why should they return? Then I was told that if there is a VIP store, and in if you talk about the year 1998 or 99, any store, any luggage store will be recognized not as a luggage store, but a VIP store. And the various names you will find, VIP Maru, VIP Junction, they used to, you know, bank upon
piggyback
the brand
that.
VIP. During that era, we were trying to create a space for Samsonite, which was not liked by the competitor, and no competitor will really welcome that. So they started to put forth a pressure indirectly, stating that return the VIP signage, return the VIP stock, because we have a policy to create exclusive stores, and therefore we don't want to have too many distributions happening in the same locality. Now imagine somebody's store, which is 80% revenue generation is from one single brand, how will they get disassociated overnight? That means it's indirectly closing down the store, which do not happen so easily. So the guy will in turn will say, kya galti ho gayi sir? And then he'll say, ki sir, aap jo kar rahe hain, wo kariye. And then the message is, well,
very clear to them over there.
So kisko wapas karenge? Naya aadmi hai, NP Singh, naya aadmi hai, kya bechega, pata nahi hai. NP Singh ko jo wapas kar do.
Okay, so this happened for how long?
Quite some time.
Okay.
Then we realized that we can't really, we need to change the rule of the game. Because with this rule, you can't win. So here the actual story started. What could have been the step, if at all I need to, I wish to throw this in front of one of you. If you were me, what would you like to do? Before I speak something, I would like to hear from one of our friends in the room. If you were me and you were treated like this in the marketplace, what will you be doing the next? Out of curiosity.
You subtly hit the competitor.
Yeah?
You subtly hit the competitor in some way.
You?
Subtly. Very softly you will hit the competitor.
Maybe your strategy could be branding or advertising.
We were doing everything possible. We used to have press ad. We used to have, first time some luggage brand has taken the Bandra, that Junction space. Big Samsonite. Everything possible was being done because it's a global brand. So definitely ABCs of the marketing are to be undertaken. Those were being done, were done very, very well.
Did you open your own stores, signature stores at very, very posh localities just for the brand to get that pull?
See, in 1998, if you go back the time, there used to be only Bata, because time today is different. You can see anybody and everybody turning into a retail brand. But 1998, 99, this was not the scenario. Frankly speaking.
Doing it, I think,
correct. But very few, very strong, very established people, because see, it requires a lot of capex, a lot of money to be pumped in without knowing what will be the outcome.
So what did
and
you do?
Another thing, the retail do not work until and unless the brand is, you know, touched, felt,
yeah,
and interacted by many, because that becomes a facilitation point to serve your customer differently. It is not the only point to cater to the customers. So was really not possible as an immediate step. Anybody else would like to give one last try, and then I get on to the formula number one.
Marketing people.
Incentivize
more to the
dealers.
Dealers.
Discounts.
Actually, frankly speaking, we started with better discount, better, what do you call it, as take home, than our competitors. How we used to calculate? VIP in those days used to be sold on 30%, 20% off. And we used to say in a locality, I'll select one dealer, you sell on MRP. 4,000 ka 20% is 800. 1,000 ka 10% is 100 rupees. So I used to give how much? 8 times the take home. So that was already taken care of. But this indirect pressure and various other reasons, we actually reached to a stage that seriously we were thinking of
band karke chale jao,
wind up karo marketing and factory chalu rahe do, because export ke liye, export mein a lot of concession we got. वो कंटिन्यू करो एंड देन इसको बंद करके घर पे जाओ. डील तो बहुत मुश्किल होता है ऐसे. नॉट या या 1000 वाज वीआईपी एग्जांपल, 4000 वाज सैमसंगाइट. इट वाज एक्सपेंसिव.
यू स्टार्टेड इन मल्टी ब्रांड रिटेल.
मल्टी ब्रांड रिटेल दैट इज
योर शॉपर स्टॉप एंड ऑल,
राइट? दैट वाज द पॉइंट. See, because we do not have enough money to get into capex ourselves.
One bag for me.
And if I add to little spice to Shopper Stop, may I?
Yeah. It's all being recorded. It's going to be on the YouTube.
The Shopper Stop was the most interesting point in my life, actually. If I have to write somewhere, I can narrate this story in such an interesting manner. I narrated in IIT Powai. I was invited 3 months before, and the dean wanted the industry player to come and share the actual experience. No theory, no drama, nothing. Actual hardcore experience. And this was narrated to them as a
case study,
and they liked it. So Shopper Stop, very quickly I'll just cover it. I went to Shopper Stop thinking that nothing else is possible, this is possible. And I used to be in and around to Andheri, so I knew only one place was Shopper Stop Andheri.
Yeah.
I went there, asked for the person, and then had a meeting. My meeting was good because he valued the brand. But when the matter went to Mr. Raheja, it turned out to be
no.
Big no,
okay.
Not no, big no. Now the reason being, a suitcase will take roughly about 3 feet, 2.5 feet, and width of at least 1.5 feet. So Mr. Raja has a point that my every inch of square feet area cost me something, and if I have to calculate the return on investment, ROI, for the space, one bag will give me how much? So value is 4,000. And turnaround will be how much? Maybe once or twice in a month, because everybody can't buy the bag like the apparel. And how much is the turnaround of the apparel? The apparel is 5 times.
Yeah.
It turn around 5. The value is near about 40-50% of it. So 5 times meaning, see the difference. He said no, and big no. He said, just do not get into this business. This is not our core area of activity. So I was thrown out. So what do you do? This was a good step to be in, but didn't work. Sometimes you know that this is the right way to do in life, but सामने वाला ही नहीं कर रहे हो तो यार तो क्या करें? So now again, if at all one person could kya kare phir big bazaar thoda value niche tha na premium and यहाँ पे मैंने बोला नहीं सर चलो फिर से एक बार फिर से ट्राई करते हैं तो व्हाट डिड आई डू इज दैट आई लेफ्ट दैट हेड ऑफिस डिस्कशन वेंट डाउन टू द ग्राउंड मीनिंग द फ्लोर लेवल एंड आई डिड नॉट इन्वॉल्व एनीबडी ड्यूरिंग दैट डिस्कशन अर्लियर आई यूज्ड टू हैव द फ्लीट रीजनल मैनेजर सेल्स ऑफिसर ब्रांच मैनेजर वी यूज टू गो 5-6 पीपल सैम्पल प्रोडक्ट पीपीटी सब भाग जाओ अभी लेट मी जस्ट ट्राई एट द ग्राउंड And then I caught hold of a young management graduate who was a category leader for the floor. And I asked him a simple thing. First of all, I took a round of the space. Then I realized there was one pillar. The moment if you had been yes. to the Shopper Stop, yeah. you go the first floor and you hit a pillar first. Wide, big pillar. And I found that space to be literally not being used well. And I asked for that space. I said, give me this pillar. I can generate in a month about 1.5 to 2 lakh rupees. He said, how? I said, I've got these categories. We used to have accessories as well. The wallet, yeah, the cross neck pouch, and locks, travel locks, straps. So I created a small display system and got it fitted with his permission, but no bag, no luggage. Because I was given no by great Mr. Raija. Okay. So okay. I could not have violated that and put the gentleman into trouble. Mm. I didn't want that to happen. The moment that was displayed, I don't know what came out from my mouth that moment. And exactly reached out to the number, very close to it. About 1.4 lakh or so I did. And then I told him that customer cannot reach out below certain height. Because he can't buy a lock from the ground, can't pick up. So you have to leave a space of about 2 feet. I said, why don't you keep one laptop back there? He permitted. yeah, perfect, good idea, it looks empty. That laptop bag was kept and I told my advertising man, I said, Andheri flyover pe ek laptop bag ka hoarding lagao. Let us see. And he sold 23 laptop bags
wow.
in 1.5 months. Because laptop bags in those days
yes.
were not very commonly available. And that was the wheeler one, the nice straps and the good organization in the front were not at all so easily available. And people found it immediately hitting their eyes and then pick it up, then connect that to the wallet and the belt and various other things. And combination ka bill ek unka 6-7,000 ka ho jata tha. And the sales went up to 3-3.5 lakhs.
And this is full MRP?
Haan, full MRP. No discount because nobody's yeah. selling. If nobody's selling, then that means there's no. And then I came to know that on the same floor, they used to have a toilet. So the toilet, I overheard the discussion that this toilet is going to be abandoned because BMC has got some issues. So they were objecting to it. Then I said, yeah, why not I reach out to now the senior management, showing this figure of 3-3.5 lakh. I could have thought of fixing up a meeting and I got a call from Shopper Stop. And they said that Mr. Nair, Salil Nair, who was the head of the Shopper Stop buying and merchandising, he wants to meet in person. I said, yaar, itna naam ho gaya mera. Pata chala, usko gussa gaya tha. Because he said no there and I was in. He called me, started with thoda sa tough note pe, but he said, yeah, you entered in like an amoeba. Now you are like an octopus and your tentacles are everywhere. You are asking for the toilet space which I have already discussed with Raymond and Levi's. And these guys are saying this brand is doing even better than them per square feet. So I'm pleasantly surprised. And that's how the discussion started. Then I asked for the space as a shop-in-shop. That was the first shop-in-shop.
Yes.
And then it was hit. Then I got Hyderabad, then I got Delhi, then Bangalore, Jaipur, various shopper stops. Then went on to lifestyle and Pantaloon. So department store was a big success, the first step, as you rightly
So the Shop and Stop concept started over there only, and now it's pretty popular. So the Shop and Stop is like they, you have your own person over there. It belongs to the
Earlier they used to have, but now we keep.
You manage it. So the stock is managed by you. Everything is managed by you.
The stock is owned by them.
Okay.
The sales interactions are managed by
them. And the whole billing is done to them directly as a bulk billing over
correct,
there.
Correct.
Okay. So that was Shop and Stop. Now coming to the Lala guys on the road,
yeah.
VIP and all. So there are a lot of Samsonite showrooms. So did you convert a VIP guy or something in a Samsonite showroom, or what did you do over there?
Never, never. Because that was my individual approach in life. As if somebody has said no, you really get something next to him, but not with that person. Not out of ego, but humans have got, to my mind, to my understanding, tremendous capacity to do whatever you want to do in your life, in positive or negative, whichever way. And I actually caught hold of a computer guy because there used to be a lot of competition. Cutthroat. And paise nahi milte hain, paise nahi milte. Bahut bikta hai, bahut billing hoti hai, paise nahi milte. Yaar, tum humara kam becho, bahut paise milenge isme.
Sunil na?
Sunil.
Future.
So, he was like flattened over the ek product bech ke kitna milta hai? I said, see, 5,000 ka MRP, you get 30%. Itna. Bolta yaar, 10 computer bech ke itna nahi milta mujhe.
So coming back to that, so Sunil over there owned at Future Tech Computers, and we were also HP dealers. So he was one of our biggest competitors. So then he signed up with Compaq over with Samsung, and he closed out his computer showroom. So for us, it was very good. We got more business. Dekho, band ho gaya. Hum log abhi tak hai, wo band ho gaya abhi tak. So that's a good part which you did over there.
So complimenting. Anyway, so it started like this, and I took the step not to approach any luggage dealer. This is another strategy which I learned for myself in life, and I keep sharing with a lot of management school students that don't go by the traditional route. That if it works with a luggage store, so go there and try out your luggage over there. No, need not to, not necessarily. So create your own route, and that's how we got into. Catch hold of somebody who is not doing so well in their business, respective business. Allow him to try out your business, and 9 out of 10 or 8 out of 10 times we were successful. All the non-traditional sellers, traders, they got into our business and they are flourishing. The most interesting interaction was with one of a Parsi lady at Warden Road. You know, Machhad Paan Wala. Opposite to that, there is a Samsung store.
Yes.
So that lady was known in the market as a person who would not like to sign anything else other than what she is dealing into. I said, yeah, chalo, mere ko milna ek baar. And the interaction started. And cross. No, I'm not keen. Money, this whole building belongs to me. So, usko kuch bhi nahi chal raha tha. Margin bhi nahi chal raha tha. No competition product bhi nahi chal raha tha. US ka brand, Samsonite aake add karega value, wo bhi nahi chalega because I'm bigger than that. Abhi kya kare? To kya karna chahiye? और पैसा भी नहीं चाहिए, मार्जिन भी नहीं चाहिए, ब्रांड वैल्यू भी नहीं चाहिए, तो उसको कैसे, हाउ विल यू? सो देयर आई टुक आउट वन मोर मंत्रा. आई सेड, हाउ मेनी SKUs यू आर हैंडलिंग टुडे? शी यूज्ड टू हैंडल अ ब्रांड कॉल्ड इंडियन टेरेन.
ओके.
एंड शी सेड अबाउट, आई डोंट नो, वो आदमी को पूछा कितने SKUs पे बेचती है. नो, इवन चेक किया तो पता चला 480 odd SKUs. So I said, in my product there are only 32 SKUs. You can remember it like your friend's name or maybe your neighbor's name. So complexity is versus 480 to 32. And you have obsolescence?
Yes.
Zero obsolescence. That's all.
Jo leftover stock hai 40% discount pe bikta hai.
Aur कितने लेफ्ट ओवर हैं, कितने के 40% में गए, यू नेवर नो टिल द टाइम यू हैव क्लोज द बिजनेस. एंड नोबडी अकाउंट्स द क्लोजिंग स्टॉक विद द डिस्काउंटिंग फैक्टर ईयर ऑन ईयर. इट हैपेंस ओनली वंस इन अ लॉन्गर टर्म. एंड देन यू रियलाइज, ओ, यू वेर टोल्ड दैट यू विल गेट 60%, बट यू अल्टीमेटली गॉट 10% बिकॉज द मोस्ट पोर्शन, द लार्ज पोर्शन वॉज सोल्ड एट 40%. सो इन माई केस, नो ऑब्सोलेसेंस. and only 32 SKUs to be tracked.
So she signed up.
Signed up, and now she's
intelligent Parsi. Okay.
So many stories, but I will not get into the stories.
So now let's get into now. Before you started this over here, the factory already was set up. So was setting up the factory important? Was India important, or you are only looking for export? And which countries you export to from? So India exports Samsung, right? By the way.
Yeah, yeah, all over the world. So the factory started the first. The idea was to first open the factory because South Asia was catered by Belgium, the Oudenaarde factory. So the distance, the timeline, everything was huge. So they used to have missed sales and all. So they wanted to have one. But India was not the first place to be selected for the production because the facilities were pathetic in those days, 95-96. So they were thinking of Malaysia.
China.
Not China actually, because they didn't want to open up in those days. And any other South Asian nations. So India was not in the first rank. But the credit goes to Dr. Tainwala, who initiated the brand to be brought to the country. He actually took the initiative and convinced them that we'll do justice with it. And we are doing justice with it.
So Dr. Tainwala was there, you had to have a JV partner when you had to do anything.
He is the JV partner.
So he's still the JV partner?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, because generally what happens is, you know, when these brands come in, no offense meant, from over there, they come, they have a nice 10-year run over there, make you earn a lot of money, and in a 10 years old, you know, our agreement is done, you are buying you out, you go and buy a new business. So that's generally what happens over there.
Yeah.
So it's quite impressive that these people are still continuing with him.
Still
so I think now the JV norms, you can have 100% retail
still
started.
Still continues with the same.
Okay.
51, 49.
Okay. Now, what is the idea behind the airport? Now, even in the domestic airport and all, you have got Samsonite all over there.
Yeah.
So this is done with partners, or is it done directly by the company?
It's done by the companies. See, because over a period of years, we really created good amount of muscle power, you can say, or wealth to spend upon brand building. Because the airport stores, they cost huge. You may end up paying somewhere around 8 to 10 lakh rupees a month.
Rent. Okay.
And the operation costs additionally. So, but now the state is different. See, because your target audience is basically a traveler.
Yes.
So whatever you do there is 100%. The TG is 100%. It's not even 99. So it's being a little overspent, but does well.
The presence is there. The brand is over there.
Yeah.
So now in the last couple of years, Samsonite has bought over a lot of brands.
Right.
So first you say, well, yeah, Samsonite, and I think now recently they bought this High Sierra also.
Yeah.
It's a very popular brand because Samsonite is that, you know, typical Rado watch, you know, Ray-Ban sunglasses
classic
kind of stuff over there, which
the
mostly
classic
people coming from Gulf and all used to have Samsonite, Ray-Ban, you know, cigarettes and all else is standard over there. But High Sierra is a very youth brand. It caters to the millennials and all, nice colors and all that stuff and all over there,
right,
which looks nice. So what was the rationale buying for buying this brand?
See,
over
basically
there?
Basically, when you don't have, you're short of some certain offering, you feel like to fill the gap. So it started with that. The Samsonite has been always core, classic, and meant for business traveler, high flying executives. So we thought of touching the youth.
Okay.
So youngsters is one category which is growing all over. So we picked up this brand too.
And did you had I think the Louis Vuitton, the managing director of Louis Vuitton, he joined Samsonite.
Yeah.
So was that a change which came into the organization for good or whatever?
Yeah, yeah. Because see, these things, they always add value. Because after that only you could see certain stores which were called as Samsonite Black Label.
Okay.
So Black
not,
Label
not that,
got
not a Johnny Walker Black Label, wala, no?
Samsonite Black Label.
Okay, Samsonite Black Label, okay.
It came into effect only after that.
Okay.
Because he thought the Samsonite has the capacity to upscale the brand positioning to the next level now. Because nobody else is there above us. Louis Vuitton is there, but Louis Vuitton is basically a very, very, what do you call it, as a niche
super premium
product. So you have only one store in whole of Mumbai. So like that. So we
so
wanted to capture that gap in between.
So in Mumbai, how many stores do you have right now?
It's roughly about 40 odd stores.
And how many are company owned and how many are franchisee?
Roughly, see, in major cities, we try to operate ourselves
okay
because it's easy.
Hmm.
But in smaller cities, you have a lot of issues of cash and other things. So we appoint
franchisees over there.
But here, roughly about 80-90% will be company owned.
So you're looking at maybe out of, if it's out of Mumbai, is it Mumbai is already, so everywhere you have Samsung, you have all these brands over there. So if you're looking somewhere out of, these are for people who want to, you know, invest in a franchise, you can catch hold of them over there, business opportunity. So supposing somebody is looking at a BOC city over there, what are the kind of investment he has to put in over there besides the cost of the place?
See, the place is like Mira Road. 5-6 years before, when the proposal came to me, and I used to sign franchises even those days. Everything I used to do, making the store, making company store, signing up franchises. So I said, yeah, Mira Road abhi nahi hai. Woh wahan pe customer hi nahi hai hamare. Because who will buy a Samsonite and get into a train? So one nahi hai. So he said, nahi sir, mera khud ka property hai. Main risk le raha hoon. I said, tum risk le raha ho, but I don't want to have failures. Mere list mein agar 5 failure aa gaye aur 100 success rahenge, to 5 mere ko problem hai. Main 100 ki problem nahi hai. I don't want you to fail. मैं आपके पास आऊँगा बट ही प्रूव मी रॉन्ग एक्चुअली
अच्छा
समटाइम्स व्हाट हैपेंस इन लाइफ दैट यू हैव डिफाइंड रिफाइंड योर प्रोडक्ट इन अ पर्टिकुलर वे दैट योर विजन एक्चुअली रिस्ट्रिक्स यू टू सी बियॉन्ड सर्टन रियलिटीज ऑफ लाइफ
वेरी करेक्ट
सो हियर आई वॉज करेक्टेड लाइक ही वॉज प्लेजेंटली सरप्राइज मिस्टर सलील नायर सो हियर आई वॉज प्लेजेंटली सरप्राइज दैट द मीरा रोड ऑल्सो कैन सस्टेन अ स्टोर नाउ इट डज अबाउट 8-10 lakh rupees and with 30% margin he's getting about 2-2.5 lakh rupees so if the property is owned you have x investment in the stock and stock investment is something like you have invested into gold frankly speaking because we don't have any product which is out of the fashion out of the scene and then you have to you know scrap it or something like that Everything gets sold. Once you have end of season sale, सब लेके आओ
यार.
येलो कलर हमने एक मंगा लिया था हमने कहा चलो यार कस्टमर्स को थोड़ा वाइब्रेंट कलर्स देते हैं तो येलो पिंक एंड वी थॉट दैट द वुमेन वुड लाइक टू बाई दोज काइंड ऑफ प्रोडक्ट बट बाद में देखा तो और भी वही खरीदते हैं ब्लैक ब्लू ग्रीन ब्लैक ब्लू ब्लू ग्रे तो कोई खरीदा ही नहीं फिर बाद में हमें वो लगाना पड़ा 30% ऑफ एंड देन एवरीथिंग
People fighting for the bags and all over there. So right now it's Samsonite. Who's your competition right now? American Tourister also you bought over.
It was already there, part of Samsonite.
Part of Samsonite. Okay.
Got it positioned.
At a different level.
At a different level.
So now who's your competition?
Frankly speaking, the competition is still VIP, but you can't call it as competition to Samsonite because the price where we play, they don't exist. So we don't really. Call it as a direct competitor, but yes, category, if you call it as, then definitely we are in the same category.
So right now, what is your position in profile in Samsonite? I think you've done everything.
I have done retail, the sales, the direct marketing, and direct selling, the consumer contact representative days were direct selling. And here, I did one more thing I got into, which is now a new brand taken over by my group. It's Lingerie? Yeah.
Okay.
It's basically a brand from Japan. It's a very popular brand, very premium brand, taken over by my JV partner. So he wants me to add that as well to...
We'll talk about that later. No? It's all being recorded over here and there are a lot of spies around over here. Okay. So you're going to launch that also? It's your JV partner is launching that. Okay.
It's not
okay.
from the Samsung.
It's not from Samsung. Okay. Okay. Good. Okay. That's good over there. Okay, online retail and discounting.
Yeah.
So today what happens is if I go to a Samsonite store, most of us go over there excepting shoes and clothes, but even shoes and clothes have started over there. People go check that shoe number and all. Okay, I'll come back in some time. Okay, well, you take credit card, na? Goes on, he goes outside the store, opens up Amazon or this, goes, gets that thing and buys it over there. So, but they don't realize sometimes those things on stock are like shoes has got a life of about a year or two.
Yeah.
Sometimes these shoes are more than 2 years old. And after some 6 months, it opens its mouth over there, and then you think, what a bad product is over. That's one of the thing over there. But are you supplying directly to the online retail like your Amazon and Flipkart? I mean, I can only say Amazon and Flipkart. Baki all are being bought off by someone or other. So are you selling directly? Do you have some kind of a franchisee or somebody who sells to them?
See, it's a reality. The online is a reality, and therefore you have to be the part of that game. So we do supply directly, but how we are managing our business is that we don't want to have a product with you here and the same product to be there and sell at MRP and sell at discount there. That creates nuisance. So we are trying to segregate the SKUs and managing it a little differently, which is helping us to have add-on business.
Okay. What is the kind of percentage of business which you got incremental because of online?
Incremental percentage, I would not be able to share out exactly, but to an extent of roughly about 10% or
10%. You think that is going to grow more?
It will.
It will grow more. But the brick and mortar stores are going to stay?
It has to, because see, you always have, I don't have to answer, because frankly speaking, these things are to be studied and learned from the market, which have actually experienced both. Now go to US, go to UK, brick and mortar are there.
Yeah, they're there.
E-commerce is there.
You would like to touch and feel that and see the zip is opening properly and what can I put, mobile dialing and then all
both.
That stuff and all.
They will complement each other.
So your shoes are all stopped. That was...
See, basically India, the market is not ready for that segment.
Shoes are achha tha yaar. Matlab 2 saal chalta tha, you don't feel like throwing it out also.
I know. Since...
Very good shoes over there. Okay, fine. So, you're totally not on social media.
Yeah.
This is one guy who doesn't have a LinkedIn profile also. And he's got one Facebook which I connected yesterday evening so I can tag him on his photographs over there. And profile photo to 20KB, 30KB, kaisa ya 20-30KB dikhega na mereko. So then ultimately I said, take one mobile phone, go out in this thing, tell somebody to click your photo, or 4MB ka file hoye, bring it to me. Then I had to sit and at the back there was a man standing over there. I had to sit and in Photoshop edit all that out and all. Then finally, tada, it was done over there. So now you realize the importance of that.
Really, really. With you, I think I'll be able to. I'm a bit shy in this part of the life.
Yeah.
So really not been able to.
Okay, so we'll help you on that. We got people to help you. Okay, so quick gun Sam, one witty answer.
Yeah.
Okay, so give me an answer. Art of living.
It came into my life when...
No, one word. That
one
I'll ask
word.
You.
Huh? Okay. The art of living is basically one word if I have to define. Happiness.
Okay. Demonetization.
A must.
India.
Uncomparable.
Okay. Mumbai. Religion.
Should be left to the people to practice.
On their own. Religion is like underwear, you know, you shouldn't show it to everybody.
Yeah.
Okay, so it's a WhatsApp joke over there. Okay, now something about your family.
We are 3 brothers, 1 sister, and we all are born and brought up in Mumbai. They are all placed in their own respective fields and different lines. So we all are happy with our own life and doing well.
Your own family. Your family.
And I have one son and 1 daughter, 2 children. Wife is housewife. Both the children are studying. Son is doing engineering, 3rd year. The daughter is doing architecture. And that's it.
So, and he's a very, very, I mean, you saw his photo with Shri Shri. Very few people get a photo with Shri Shri over there, and that too he was kneeling over there. Kneel bhi karta hai, I'm not going to kneel. So, tell us something about how Art of Living came into your life.
Yeah.
Thoda, man. Like, yeah. I know it can go on and on. Art
I know,
of Living.
I'll so, just touch upon.
Yeah.
See, this was the time when I was promoted as to head the retail for South Asia. So, I was very happy that I did good job here. So, I was promoted to handle whole of South Asia and then go around, expand the retail everywhere. But frankly speaking, sometimes in life when you get bigger than what you can chew, digest, it leads to problem. It's like, you know, 2 rasgulle ka pet hai aur aapko 10 rasgulla khilaye to kya hoga? Lot of pain and ache. So there were a lot of issues because I was undergoing through a lot of stress. A lot of travel, then handle the own job here in the country and then travel back and then come back. So it was leading to a lot of mental stress. And then I came across to this process of breathing technique to be learned from someone. And fortunately, my teacher was a IITian. So he explained me extremely in a scientific manner and then got into it. It actually helped me to de-stress.
Okay.
That's it. Meaning, if somebody wants to experience it, he should learn it, do it himself, and experience whether it works or not work, because it may not work with someone, I don't know, but it worked fantastically well with me.
So how did you get that photo with Shri Shri? He's very...
Oh, that was because a couple of initiatives I recommended. I said if they have, they're doing such good work, and not only me, then I started to come across to many people. Like for example, I used to drink quite often, but drink went off my table on its own, meaning I did not have to leave. And then a couple of more things. So I said, hey, ye hota kaise? Then I went back to my IITM teacher. He said, see, it actually reformats your mind. This breathing, ka jo pattern hai, it formats. So the moment the formatting happens, uske baad jo wrong file hai, wo delete hota hai automatically. Tumhare liye jo wrong hai, ho sakta hai kisi ke liye right ho. So you will find someone who drinks and yet he does his pranayam. But there'll be guys who would end up deleting it. So it depends upon person to person. So it's good. Whatever is happening, just allow it to. Look at this guy. He pointed out to someone. He says, see, he still enjoys his 3 bottles of beer, but still he does his pranayam very regularly. Good. So there are different people.
Fantastic. Maybe there is. Narendra, fantastic. Thank you so much. Really enjoyed it. And
indeed.
Please, it was fantastic. Can you hold the mug? So oh, that's for you.
Very nice. So nice, yeah. So nice. Thank you so much.